Hello, my name's Tara. I'm a digital marketing executive here at Koozai, and today I'm going to be talking about some of my favourite tools at the moment. So these range from social media tools to keyword research tools, and I've picked these 10 just because they're personally ones I like to use. We'll start with similar pages. This is a Chrome plugin, so if you find a page that you're getting particular value out of, maybe it's good as a link building resource, you can use the similar pages plugin to see other pages that Google thinks are similar. This can uncover some great new kind of resources to get links from. It's also nice at the beginning of a project, if you're looking to see what Google perceives as similar to your site, it's a good way of finding that out. Wayback Machine. This is a really cool tool if you've got a site and, for example, conversions have dropped just before you took it on. So you need to think, has something on page changed, but you don't maybe know what the site looked like previously. You can use the Wayback Machine to look at a cached version of the site, so you can see what it looked like previously and decipher whether maybe something's changed which has caused the drop in conversions. GSiteCrawler is a brilliant tool for XML sitemaps. It's nice because you can set priorities for the pages and frequencies, and it also formats it nicely with a good GSS file. Crowd Booster is a social media tool which lets you see how much your followers have increased or decreased by, who interacts with your post most, and who are your most valued followers. So it's great as evaluating any social media campaign. It gives you a good indication of what's going on, and it can be used for Facebook and Twitter. Google Webmaster Tools. This is quite an obvious tool, but at the moment I think it's particularly important because with all the algorithm updates that are happening, if Google are giving you information from Google Webmaster Tools, then these are obviously things that they're taking into consideration. So anything you read in Webmaster Tools and any information you can get from there is obviously important to your website's performance within Google. Copyscape is a brilliant tool for checking if you've got any duplicate content issues. So for example, it could be on page on your own site or it could be on another site. Because it's checked on a page-by-page basis, it can be either way, it doesn't matter where it is online, Copyscape will find it. It also shows you kind of the degree to which the content is copied. So if it's the odd sentence, it will highlight that, or if it's anything more, it will let you know as well. Screaming Frog is a brilliant tool. It's another crawling tool. It can be used for so many different things, from sitemaps to pretty much anything. The reasons I like to use it, it nicely shows you a column of your status code so you can quickly export any 404s that you've got. Also, it's quite useful if you're doing keyword research. You can put a competitor's site through there and export their title tags, and from that maybe see ideas for new keywords you could go after. Ubersuggest is a keyword research tool. It's brilliant because it's based on current searches. So anything that's in Google at the moment in Google Suggest, it scrapes the data from that, basically taking your keyword and looking at what all the suggestions would be before it and after it, kind of going through the alphabet. So it's really nice for current and up-to-date ideas for titles and content and anything that needs to be really fresh. Majestic SEO is something I use all the time for backlink analysis. In particular, within Majestic, I would pay attention to your IP analysis and your anchor text. This can show you if you've got an unnatural kind of balance of brand and non-brand anchor text, and within your IPs, whether you've got too many links from one IP. Penguin is a fantastic tool at the moment. It accesses Google Analytics from your profile, and it will overlay recent algorithm updates against your traffic. So if you've had a huge drop in traffic and there's an algorithm update just before, it could be that that's something that's causing the issue. With that tool though, it's important to not jump to conclusions and think this must be the reason for the drop. There might be other reasons. So although it's a really good indication if you've got a suspicion that an algorithm update is behind the drop, still do lots of research and background to make sure you've checked all other avenues. So that's all the tools I've covered today. Obviously there are lots of other tools out there. If you've got any you want to share, feel free to leave them in the comments below. And if you want to follow us on any of the social media profiles, they are also listed below.